So far, no difference. I know what's gonna happen. And I know how to solve this version of it. Version?
test chamber. Escape contingency not in place.
Alright, good. Looks like it doesn't know where the elevator is heading to. Up ahead are the overgrown parts of the facility. I can try to reroute the elevator again if it holds up. There is an office area nearby from the same time period when Aegis was first installed. Maybe we can get some information from there. So, I was right! When a test subject destroyed her, this whole place fell into disrepair. I don't exactly know if everything is working properly anymore, but we don't have a choice.
Error. Tracking on target failed. Heavy organic interference.
Huh? It worked? It's blind here. Oh, no. No. There's some stuff here blocking the path for the elevator. Hold on for emergency brakes. Just climb on out of here, and let's get moving. That was close. You could have been in there. Oh, wait, you just were.
Now for chapter 4. Where it's overgrown in this section of the facility.
Ooh, these are the old offices I was talking about before. The humans left these behind when she gassed them with neurotoxin. Because this is an abandoned track, it's no longer connected to the rest of the computer systems. Aegis shouldn't be able to lock us out here. These computers should contain a lot of useful information for us. Alright, time to start hacking into these systems. Let's start guessing passwords. Password. Admin? Oh, come on! Let me in. Were these passwords generated by super geniuses? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6? What? All these passwords are usually the same. 0000. Oh, for crying out loud! I didn't even get a warning siren this time. This thing must be laughing at me now. I know these aren't sentient, but still. Black Mesa sucks. Seriously? Hold on. I think I just got locked out. I'm getting something that says, contact administrator for additional support. What? Administrator? There's no one left in the facility. All we have left are cores. There's no way I just failed hacking this thing. I hacked Aegis and hacked the nanobots to keep my testing track alive, but somehow I can't hack something as simple as a few computers in a big room. Oh, I think it's the plants. It must be the plants that are interfering with my Wi-Fi or something. You know what? If I stare at it long enough, my Wi-Fi nodes will override something. Maybe. I'll give it a shot.
Or I could press this big red button.
Did you just override the admin controls? Anyway, I think there's some info here about Aegis. I'll keep working, long as you keep going. So, get back to the testing track and get started. Oh, I should also let you know, I won't be able to move around much. Management rails are kinda non-existent here, unless I wanna fall off another one and end up back in the junkyard. You won't be seeing much of me right now. Right, there is a lot of information stored in these computers. It'll take me some time to sort through these and come up with a plan so we can get rid of Aegis. According to the systems, the toxic goo is still rising. You should continue to move through the tests and upwards. Keep your feet dry.
I can notice a difference straight away with this version. I mean, the edited version, or story mode, did not have that pool of toxic goo. At least I don't think it had that. Which means that catching the cube in the pits is not just... non-viable, but... well, it's suicidal! Yeah, we need to redirect the laser to deactivate the emancipation grill to get the other cube. The cube that I can get. The cube that I need in order to keep the excursion funnel on. I'll probably ask this around the time I upload one of me Shrine of Psychosis vlogs. Visions, whatever you want to call them. But do you think I should do the Art of Therapy testing course? As I think came with... the DLC that's... Perpetual Testing Initiative came with. Why am I getting the two confused? Well, it's some form of DLC, anyway. Apparently it has conversion gel, which is surprisingly absent from this game. Conversion gel makes unportable surfaces portable. Although it can be washed off by water. Unlike the manufactured walls. Although it has corroded over time. Find a way of getting that second without falling into the toxic goo. I'll need to think about this. I may also consider creating some more trials of psychosis. Yes! I shall create more pleasures! Deceptively easy.
one which
the developers at Valve consider too cruel, too twisted. Well, to be honest with them, I think they're being too kind with some of them! That's why I make my test chambers fiendishly difficult. The kind of difficult that the advanced test chambers in the original Portal, or the advanced test chambers in this. Now, who would like me to play some of my trials of psychosis that I've forgotten how to solve? And perhaps make new ones. Would you like me to taste my own pleasures? Would you like me to hear my cries of pleasure? If so, put it in the comments, and I shall take it into consideration. That reminds me, when I start uploading Portal Stories Mel, I shall have to set up a straw poll to help decide what follows. I shall announce it. In fact, the decision will probably have already been made by the time you see this. Whatever you have chosen, I hope this will be interesting. Oh, and as for Dark Souls 3, money is a bit tight right now, at the time of recording this. So I'll be doing that once either the money situation has improved, there's a sale on, or well, no, there's no all of this, and the DLCs have been released. I mean, they wouldn't just put a season pass for DLC for purely aesthetic things, like additional items in existing areas. No. With the first game, it was Artorias of the Abyss, which was included as part of the Prepare to Die edition. Now that was a tough one. Then there was Dark Souls 2, with Crown of the Sunken King, which included the origins of the Archdrake sect. and a difficult to navigate city under the ground. Now there was one optional boss fight, which reminded me why I didn't do PvP in either of the first two Dark Souls games. Yeah, that boss fight. I had to fight dirty with that one. It's the kind that would require... Remember to stay on the other side of the Emancipation Grill. It's the kind that would require a... Benny Hill-style chase sequence at 2.5 times normal speed, with Yakety Sax playing in the background. Then we have Crown of the Old Iron King. Which had a boss which was more than just a reskin of a previous one. This also had a different damage type. And there are a couple bosses there. One optional, one not so optional. That required agility. Carefully timed strikes to cause damage, rather than kill. Because taking the beating and then dishing it out is costly on stamina. Downright suicidal. I mean the not-so-optional boss, which had a 93% failure rate. Why did I say it like that? Yeah, a 93%... Can't get the words in! A 93% failure rate. Yeah. Apparently it was that difficult. And then there's this one which... I'm not that good at. To trigger the special conditions for the... unique ending of that fight. Let's just say it involves flawless victory in seppuku. And yeah, I made Mortal Kombat reference, so please don't bother pointing that out. Yeah. The Old Iron King included a tower which is where the iron was dug out for the Iron Keep, which sunk in the lava. Then there's the third, final DLC, Crown of the Ivory King, in a frozen wasteland. Aesthetically pleasing. If you ignore the invisible threats and ice-based sorcery. Optional area where demonic ponies can appear in the blizzard.
minutes.
I'm hoping for a boss fight in the Dark Souls 3 DLCs. I'm hoping for a giant rabbit boss. Well, considering that... That Solaire War is a reference to. Why not? And the Black Knights. Don't get me started on those. Oh yeah. I didn't go for heavy amounts of sorcery in either of the two games, so that's why I'll be doing that with the third one. Yeah, I know, you've probably heard that a few times now. No. That's not it. Yeah, I know I've been a bit off topic. But would you rather me talking about me failing over and over again? It's obviously so simple that I didn't think of it. And this is And right now I need to get over there in order to get the other cube and open the exit.
Some of the stuff. So many cat pictures. But I also got some more serious information. Aegis thinks we killed the scientists, so it's activating some sort of kill order. It's going to flood the enrichment center, probably with all that goo, to eliminate any and all threats. That means you, that means me, and that means whatever that last thing is. So I'd suggest we keep moving.
Strange, where there's some portable walls below on the bits where either it is or I'm remembering it wrong. Although I will need repulsion gel to be painted around here.